Good morning, everybody. Today, my topic is migration, migration of fishes. The group of fishes moving from one place to another is known as the migration. In 1978, Robin R. Baker defined migration is the act of moving from one spatial unit to another. So let's see the migration. These are the type of migration. Migration type is, the first is the elemental migration. Elemental migration is the in search of food and water. These fishes are migrating from one place to another in search of food and water. This is the elemental migration. The second is the gametic migration. Gametic migration is the migration happening for the reproduction purpose, for breeding, for spawning. This category of fishes is coming, this gametic migration. And the next type is climatic migration. That is, to secure a suitable climate, this migration is happening. That is the climatic migration. Next is the osmoregulatory migration. That is, to satisfy the osmoregulatory function, the fishes are moving, the fishes are swimming, the fishes are migrating from one place to another. So today, let's see about the pattern of migration. That is, the one is the anadromous migration, the other is the catadromous migration. The form or pattern of migration in different species is different. Today, we can see the anadromous migration and catadromous migration. Anadromous migration. Example, salmon. This anadromous migration, they migrate the fishes from sea to freshwater. That is, the fish is living in the sea, and for the purpose of breeding and spawning, they are migrating from sea to freshwater. So what happened in the case of the salmon? The salmon is traveling thousands of kilometers from the sea, and it reaches the river. And after reach the river, it find a secure place for spawning. And after spawning, the salmon is died. So what happened? The salmon is died, and this egg spawn into the larvae. And this larvae is, that is the fish fry, the young fish. The young fishes live in the mud. And after day, this metamorphoses into adult, and again this process is continuing. This is the anadromous migration. That is, migration of the fishes from sea to freshwater. The fishes, the salmon fishes living in the sea. And in the sea, the time of migration, the time of breeding, the time of they are started their movement. They are going towards the river. They are going towards the freshwater for to find out a safe place for spawn. And this is the anadromous. Please remind that the anadromous migration is from sea to freshwater. Next is the catadromous migration. Catadromous migration is just opposite to the anadromous migration. Catadromous migration, that is freshwater to sea. The fishes are living in the freshwater more time, and they migrated to the sea for their breeding and their spawning purpose. So for example, Ancula ancula, that is the European eel. The life history of the European eel is that in two colors we can observe. That means one is the yellow eel, the other is the silver eel. The yellow eel is the larval period, the young eel. And what happened? This young eel live in the fresh water. That is, in the case of the male, 8 to 10 years old, they live in the fresh water. And in the case of female, they are 10 to 18 years, they live in the fresh water. And the color of the body is yellow. So what happened? After this 8 to 10 years or 10 to 18 years, they slowly change their color. This yellow color is slowly changed to the silver color. That means it shows that they are ready to migrate. That is, certain features are appear in the body. That is, secondary sexual characters is developed in the body of the eel. So what are the secondary sexual characters? This eel is ready to go to the migration. So what happened? This yellow eel, that is in this yellow eel, stop feeding. It's not taking any food. It stopped feeding, and the body is also changed the color, and this eye become large because it's going to swim. It save all the energy. The eyes become large and the lip become thin. So it's ready for migrate to freshwater, to sea. In the case of this European eel, that is Angula, it travels thousands of kilometers. So it needs the energy, because the fish living in the freshwater and it travels thousands of kilometers and it reaches the sea for breeding and spawning. It is believed that this eel is traveling 3,000 to 4,000 kilometers. It crossed the Atlantic Ocean and it reached the West Bermuda. And what happened when it reached the West Bermuda? It spawned at the depth of 400 to 500 meters. After the spawning, it is the parent will die. The parent will die. It's after the spawning. It's happening like this. This is the migration of Catadromous migration. What happened? These parents are die. When it reached the Bermuda, these parents are die, and this egg, that is its spawn, and this young one is metamorphosis. What is metamorphosis? The changes is happening. That is, the first is the leptocephalus larvae. The first larvae is the leptocephalus larvae, and it changed to elver larvae. It will take some time. That is, the changes happening in the freshwater, because the migration is catadromous migration. So it will live in the freshwater. Maybe because the female is taking 18 years, 10 to 18 years to become mature. In the case of the male is taking 8 years to mature. So it live in the fresh water. And when they reach the maturity, what happened? They start the migration. This larvae is going and this process is continuing. So today we studied about two type of migration. Anadromous migration and catadromous migration. One is opposite to the one is from this anadromous migration is from sea to freshwater, and this catadromous migration is freshwater to sea. Okay?